And she asks us to think about the point where race and gender intersect.
Alexis Harris teaches sociology at the University of Washington.
I teach health inequalities and social problems in society and racial disparities.
But she had to take leave from doing so as she dealt with a case of her own. A bone marrow biopsy discovered she had a rare blood cancer.
Just being told that you have, 18 to 24 months to live was pretty scary.
Treatment involved intensive chemotherapy and then a bone marrow transplant. But finding a match would be a challenge.
And we know that people of color are underrepresented on the bone marrow registry list, and that directly leads to people of color not having matches and dying.
Matches are determined by HLA types, which usually go along with similar ethnic backgrounds.
There is just a great diversity in the HLA haplotypes for African American patients. And so it would take many, many, many more African American donors or underrepresented minority donors to be able to find matches.
Alexis's twin brother wasn't a match. Two potential donors from the registry declined to move forward, and a third turned out to be herself. Alexis had signed up when she was in college.
That was a perfect match for myself. I always say it was my 20-year-old self trying to save my 40-year-old self. But I've also been a fighter, and for some reason I really felt strongly that I wasn't going to die then.
Alexis eventually got a cord blood transplant. It doesn't have to be as closely matched with the patient. She's now back to doing what she loves and encouraging others to join the registry.
So I just think it's an easy way to be a real superhero and save someone's life. Like, who can say that they've saved somebody's life? Like, not a whole lot of people.
From the UW Medicine newsroom in Seattle, I'm Katie Chen.